behind, I'll be behind him right here.
Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Es gusto verlos una vez más. It's a joy to see everybody once again. On this day here, you can see the background today. Que estamos aquí en un trasfondo que tenemos. Kind of a little hot day. Es un día medio caliente. But that still does not stop us. Aún el calor no nos para de servir a nuestro Creador. He should never stop us from serving our Creator. No matter what circumstance or situation we're in, no importa qué circunstancia nos encontramos en nuestra vida. Es importante que lo adoremos, that we worship and praise Him, and we continue to serve Him. Everybody way back there hears me? Okay, todos me oyen. Everybody's able to hear me. If we could all open to our word, podemos abrir nuestra palabra. A la palabra de Yahweh, Yahweh's word. And we're going to be opening up in Hebrews, el libro de Ibrim, the book of Ibrim, which is Hebrews, el libro de Hebreos, capítulo 13, chapter 13. Chapter 13. Let's go ahead and pray. Vamos a orar. Father, we come before you, Father, this Shabbat. Venemos, Padre, delante de ti en este Shabbat, Padre, para honrarte y alabarte, to honor you and to praise you, Father. For your word says, Father, that we must enter into rest, que tenemos que entrar a descanso, y descanso en él. We have to enter into rest with our Father, con nuestro Padre, because our Father rested on this day. And if we want to honor the Father, si queremos honrar al Padre, we have to honor him and rest together with him. Father, for that we give you thanks. Pero te damos gracias, Padre. May your word reach the innermost parts of our being. Que tu palabra llegue a los lugares más profundos de nuestro ser. En el nombre de Yeshua HaMashiach, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, your son which shed his blood for each and every one of us, que derramó su sangre para cada uno de nosotros. Amén and amén. As we are in the book of Hebrews, estamos en el libro de Hebreos, chapter 13, verse 1. We're going to talk about seven verses. Vamos a hablar de siete versos aquí. Though I could give you more verses, if you want to take notes, quien tomar notas, we probably won't read them. No lo vamos a leer, but I have them written down so you could have a reference of other scriptures that go with that scripture. Otras escrituras que van con esa escritura. So if you want to take note of that, that's good, and then if not after, I could give them to you after also. Te los puedo dar después. But it says in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 1. I'm going to go ahead and read it, and then y lo voy a leer y voy a pedirle a José si lo lee fuerte donde él está. He can read it loud. Where he's at in Spanish. Let the brotherly love continue.
Permanezca en el amor fraternal.
We see here that it is not such a large sentence. No es una frase tan larga. Pero está diciendo aquí que mantengamos el amor. That we maintain ourselves in love. That is the key element. You know, I've always told, you know, we're going to have trials. We're going to have tribulation. Vamos a tener pruebas. Vamos a tener tribulación. But one thing I know for sure, una cosa que yo estoy seguro, if you want to escape, si quieres escapar the tribulation, tribulación, you have to have the love. Tienes que tener el amor. Porque la palabra lo dice. La palabra en Apocalipsis habla y nos dice, in Revelation talks to us and teaches us that if we have love, you will be spared of the time of trial. Vas a ser, no te va a pasar nada durante el tiempo de prueba. You will be maintained, va a ser mantenido. Eso es importante. Hay otras escrituras que nos hablan de su amor, como Romanos 12:10, Romans 10:12, 1 Thessalonians 4:9, 1 Thessalonians 4:9, 1 Peter or 1 Kefas 1:22, 1 Kefas 1:22, 1 Peter also chapter 2 verse 17, Primera de Kefas, capítulo 2, verso 17. And also chapter 3, verse 8. También capítulo 3, verso 8. All of these speak of his love and maintaining in his brotherly love. Que nos mantengamos en su amor. Eso es algo que nos está diciendo. Stay in his love. Mantente en su amor. You know, we've always heard that he has said that when I return, will I find love? ¿Encontraré amor? Because scripture also says that the love of many will grow cold. Porque el amor de muchos se enfriará. And we are noticing, and we see around. If you watch the news, si ve las noticias, it's not even news. And it's not even the good news. Y ni son las buenas nuevas tampoco. All it is bad news. Because fear sells. Porque el temor se vende. They want to instill fear in you. Quieren poner temor en ti. They always look for the best shot. Busquen la mejor foto. They don't want to show you the other side. No te quieren mostrar el otro lado. They always want to show you just the good side, supposedly, or the side they want to show you. El lado que ellos te quieren mostrar. That's what the media does. It's all about ratings. Todo es por agarrar puntos. Has nothing to do with you to be informed. No tiene nada para que tú estés informado o que yo esté informado. Sino quieren tenerte allí. They want to have you there. So they can program you. Para que te puedan programar. That's why it's called television. Por eso se llama televisión. Because they want to tell you the vision you should be having. Ellos te quieren enseñar la visión que tú tienes que ver. Ellos te están diciendo la visión. De lugar de tener visión, instead of having visions of Yahweh and his, of the things in his scripture, de la cosa de su escritura, you're being manipulated, estás siendo manipulado para tener esas visiones, to have those visions. And isn't it interesting that they call it channels, canales? Because there's different channels or different paths. Hay muchos caminos. But the word teaches us that there's only one way. No más hay un camino. And that way is Yeshua Messiah. Amen? Let's read verse 2. Do not forget to receive strangers, for by so doing, some have unwillingly entertained messengers. José, léalo, verso 2.
Pero no se olviden de ser amistosos con los de afuera, pues haciendo esto, algunos sin saberlo hospedaron a Malaquín.
I'm going to give you a couple of other scriptures so you can write them down. Genesis 18, 1 and 2. Genesis 18, 1 y 2. Genesis 19, 1 y 2. Genesis 19, 1 and 2 also. And Matthew 25, 35. Y Mateo 25, 35. All these scriptures speak on how we should treat strangers. ¿Cómo debemos de tratar al extranjero? We're supposed to treat him with courtesy and kindness, con cortesía y con amor. Because if we have love, we have to share love and give love. Debemos compartir y dar amor. Es lo que tenemos que hacer. And he says, you know, you got to be careful, tiene que tener cuidado, because you don't know that you might be entertaining, vas a estar teniendo tiempo con unos malaquims, with some messengers, some angels. You see, Abraham entertained angels. One of them was Yeshua. Uno era Yeshua que estaba ahí, the son of Elohim. Él estaba ahí con él hablando. And the other two went to Sodom and Gomorrah. Los otros dos se fueron a Sodoma y Gomorrah. And they referred to them as men. Se referieron a ellos como hombres. Why? Because that was their appearance. Be ministering to somebody and you won't even know that it might be an angel. Puede ser un ángel que estás ahí contigo.
Yeah.
You know, so it's important that the way you treat them with respect and honor, right. Respeto y amor. I mean, they could appear as a homeless person. Se puede aparecer como una persona que es de la calle. And you don't even know. See, because Yeshua says there in verse chapter 25, 35, he says, I was hungry and you fed me. Tenía hambre y me diste de comer. Tenía sed y me diste de beber. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. And they're all saying, what do you mean? We haven't seen you who gave you? ¿Quién te dio? The thing is, Abraham fed him. Abraham le dio de comer. Because he was there with them. So we got to be careful on how we treat people we don't know. ¿Cómo tratar a gente que no conocemos? 3, verso 3. Remember the prisoners as if chained with them, and those being mistreated, since you yourself also are in the body. See?
Recuerden aquellos en prisión y los que están siendo maltratados como si ustedes estuvieran en prisión con ellos y soportando sus torturas en sí mismos.
Amén. I'll give you a couple of other reference scriptures. Te voy a dar otra escritura de referencia. Matthew 25, 36. Mateo 25, 36. Romans 12, 15. Romanos 12, 15. 1 Corinthians 12, 26. 1 Corinthians 12, 26. Colossians 4, 18. Colosenses 4, 18. Hebrews 10, 34. Y Hebreos 10, 34. You know, when somebody's going through something, it says you have to be as if you're going through it. If somebody's in chains, you have to be as if you are in chains. Se queda como si tú también estás en cadenas. Because ourselves, nosotros mismos, tenemos que sentir lo que los otros sienten. We have to feel what they feel and go through what they go through. Because when you love somebody, cuando tú amas a alguien y tú tienes el amor, you're going to feel their pain. Tú vas a sentir el dolor de ellos. Why? Because there's no selfishness in you. No hay egoísmo en ti.
Right.
You know what it is to hurt. Tú sabes lo que es estar en dolor. So us ourselves have to share the love. Tenemos que compartir ese amor. Que alguien está pasando por algo. So it says, suffer with those that who suffer. Sufre con los que sufren. And they also rejoice. Gózate también con los que se gozan.
Hallelujah.
Somebody's rejoicing. You're not going to be jealous.
No.
No te vas a gozar si alguien está gozando.
Because
usually you see somebody getting blessed sometimes and you go, what about me? ¿Y yo qué? ¿Por qué yo no? Then you're being jealous. No. We cannot have that attitude. No podemos tener esa actitud. If we are of the body, if we are of the kingdom, hacemos del reino. No debemos tener esa actitud. Let's go ahead and go to Hebrews 4. Let marriage be respected by all, and the bed be undefiled. But Elohim shall judge those who whore and adulterers. Léalo fuerte en español, José.
El matrimonio es honroso en todo sentido, y en particular el sexo dentro del matrimonio es puro, pero Yahweh en verdad castigará a los fornicarios y a los adúlteros.
I'm going to give you a couple of scriptures of reference. Te voy a dar una escritura de referencia. 1 Corinthians 6:9, 1 Corintios 6:9, 1 Corinthians 7:38, 7:38, Galatas 5:19-21, Galatians 5:19-21, 1 Timothy 1 Timoteo 4:3. Dice que el matrimonio debe de ser respetado y ser honroso. The marriage has to be respected and undefiled. In other words, anything that is out, any sexual practice, cualquier práctica sexual que no es conforme fue diseñada, the way it was designed, is an abomination. Es una abominación. Because there's even a scripture, hay una escritura que dice, does not nature itself teach you that it's wrong? ¿Aún la naturaleza no te enseña que es mal? There was a perfect design. Había un diseño perfecto entre el hombre y la mujer, between a man and a woman. Though others might try to twist scripture, otros tratarán de torcer la escritura, but that is the only way the blessing could come. Es la única manera que la bendición viene. Because the seed is deposited in a place of life. Porque la semilla es depositada en un lugar de vida. But others that practice other practices, otros que practican otras prácticas, deposit their seed in place of which is destruction, and depositan la semilla en lugares que es de destrucción. In the place where the garbage is deposited, donde la basura es depositada. So tenemos que tener cuidado, we have to be careful. And we cannot accept anything beyond of what the scripture teaches us. Tenemos que aceptar lo que la escritura dice. It's not our words, it's not my words, no son mis palabras, son las de él. Lo que él ha dicho y ha enseñado. Podemos tratar de cambiar lo que normal es. We can try to change things. But no matter what we do to try to change, what is up is up, what is down is down. Lo que es para arriba y lo que es para abajo es para abajo. What is right is right, and what is left or left and right, there's no in between, no hay entremedio. O algo, otra dirección. Amén. So let's go to the next verse. Vamos al siguiente verso. Verse 5. Let your way of life be without the love of silver, and be satisfied with what you have. For he himself has said, I shall never leave you nor forsake you. 5, José. Fuerte.
Mantengan sus vidas libres del amor al dinero y estén satisfechos con lo que tienen, pues Yahweh mismo ha dicho, yo nunca les fallaré ni les abandonaré.
Let me give you a couple more reference scriptures. Deuteronomy 31:6, Deuteronomios 31:6-8, and also verse 8. Joshua 1:5, Josué 1:5, Philippians 4:11, Filipenses 4:11, 1 Timoteo 3:3, 1 Timothy 3:3. Estas escrituras, these scriptures, tells us, see, money in itself is not the problem. El dinero en sí mismo no es el problema. The silver, el oro, la plata, It's the having of the love, el teniendo amor, or depositing your faith, depositando tu fe en el dinero. See, when we need health, necesitamos salud, el dinero, you might be able to pay for better doctors, quizás pagas por mejores doctores, but when there's a disease that cannot be cured, una enfermedad que no se puede curar, it doesn't matter how much money you have, no importa cuánto dinero tengas, no vas a poder cambiar la situación. You cannot change the situation. It can only be changed through the love in the Messiah. El amor en el Mesías. Our love in the Creator. Nuestro amor en el Creador. Because in Him is life. Porque en Él está la vida. En Él está todo. And again, he tells us, lo dice, que Él es nuestro ayudador. I mean, he will never forsake us. Él nunca los va a dejar. See, that's one thing we got to know, that whatever word Yahweh gives, la palabra que Yahweh da, la cumple. He fulfills it. He is faithful. Él es fiel to the end. Let's go to the next verse. Vamos al siguiente verso. 6. So what we boldly say, Yahweh is my helper, I shall not fear what man shall do to me. El 7, hermano.
Por lo tanto, podemos decir con confianza, Yahweh es mi ayudador, no estoy temiendo qué es lo que un ser humano me puede hacer.
I'm going to give you some reference scriptures. Psalms 27:1, Salmos. Salmo 56, 4 y 11. Psalms 56, 4 and 11. Psalms 118, 6 and 7. Salmo 118, 6 y 7. You see, Yahweh is my helper. Yahweh es mi ayudador. I shall not fear what man shall do to me. No voy a temer lo que el hombre me va a hacer. You know, His word says, su palabra dice, do not fear what man can do to you. No tema lo que el hombre te puede hacer. But fear the one that could kill your body and cast your soul to the lake of fire. De que el que puede destruir tu cuerpo y alma y lanzarte al lago de fuego. That is the one we must fear. Not man. Man can destroy this earthly vessel. El hombre puede destruir este cuerpo. But he cannot do nothing to my soul. Pero no puede hacerle nada a mi alma. If anybody has ever seen that movie Braveheart. Si muchos han visto la película Braveheart, que es Corazón con Denuedo. Una de Mel Gibson, one of Mel Gibson's movies. Es una historia real, it's a true story. At the end when they're killing him, cuando lo están matando, he yells freedom. Él grita, libertad. Why? Because no matter if they're killing him, lo estén matando, él es libre. They could take away your physical body. Te pueden quitar tu cuerpo físico. But your inner being, tu ser de adentro, nunca lo pueden tocar. Unless you allow it. Solamente que tú lo permitas. That's why they want you to believe the lie of the devil. Que crea la mentira del diablo. Verso 7. Remember those leading you, who spoke the word of Elohim to you. Consider the outcome of their behavior and imitate their belief. José.
Recuerden a sus dirigentes, los que les hablaron el mensaje de Yahweh, reflexionen sobre los resultados del modo de vida de ellos. Permite la confianza en Yahshua que ellos tienen.
I'm going to give you a couple of reference scriptures. Te voy a dar una escritura de referencia. One of them you probably won't have. You have to look it up in a different book. Usted que ve otro libro, it's the book of wisdom, el libro de sabiduría, 2:17, wisdom 2:17, Hebrews 6:12, Hebreos 6:12, capítulo 13, verse 13, verse 17, chapter 13, verse 17 of Hebrews, capítulo 13, verso 17 de Hebreos, Hebrews 13:24, Hebreos 13:24. I'm going to tell you what Wisdom 2:17 says. Les voy a leer lo que dice Sabiduría 2:17. Let us see if his words are true. Hay que ver si sus palabras son real. Let us test what will happen at the end of his life. Vamos a probar a ver qué va a pasar al fin de su vida. The thing is, it says, remember those who leading you. Que te acuerdes de lo que te están dirigiendo. Because many people in your life or in my life have at one time or another have led us, nos han dirigido. And it's talking about the word, la palabra, que se ha hablado en nuestra vida, that has been spoken to our life. Sometimes we don't see the word or the promise. No vemos la promesa o la palabra que se nos dijo. Until time comes or passes. Hasta que el tiempo pasa o viene. Pero está diciendo ahí como dice en el libro de sabiduría, en the book of wisdom. In time you will see at the end. Al final tú vas a ver que la palabra se cumple. That the word is fulfilled. His word is always fulfilled. Su palabra de él todo el tiempo se cumple. Su palabra de él es fiel. His word is faithful. He is faithful in every word that he has spoken to us. En cada palabra que ha hablado hacia nosotros. We should never lose faith. No pierdamos la esperanza. No pierda la fe. Even with all this that is going on. If you notice, what they want to cause in you is fear. Lo que quieren causar es temor. Why? Because fear can control you. Temor te puede controlar. He says he has not given us a spirit of fear. Porque no nos ha dado un espíritu de temor. But he has given us a sound mind. Una mente sana. That means that you're not going to be having double minded. No va a tener dos pensamientos. Oh, I trust today, tomorrow I don't. Hoy confío, mañana no.
Right.
No. You got to always trust him. Be faithful. Ser fiel. Because he is faithful. Porque él es fiel.
Amen.
Espero que estas palabras lleguen a su ser. I hope these words reach you. And you're able to live the word. Y puedan vivir la palabra. Que nos ha dado él a cada uno de nosotros. He's given each and every one of us. Father, we give you thanks this day, Father, again. Te damos gracias, Padre, otra vez por este día. Because you are worthy to be praised. Tú eres digno de ser honrado. Y a ti te honramos, Padre. And we honor you, Father. For you alone are worthy. Porque tú eres digno, Padre. We give you thanks for this Sabbath. Te damos gracias por este Shabbat. That you are worthy to praise. Tú eres digno de ser adorado. Father, we have asked you that you give us the strength to endure to the end. For the word says, he that endures to the end shall be saved. Porque la palabra dice, el que permanece hasta el fin será salvo. So we are going to have troubles. Tendremos pruebas. But we have to maintain in the path. Mantenernos en el camino. Y con eso los dejo. En paz. Y en paz nos envía. I leave you in peace, he said, and in peace I send you. Amen and amen. Shabbat shalom.
What?